My apologies for all of you all that we are about 7 minutes or so late on today. But even in that, God is still good. Certainly, we stand in the need of prayer, and we definitely welcome the Holy Spirit's presence. And Lord, you know what we stand in the need of. And our prayer, Heavenly Father, is that you would anoint this service, that you would touch, that your Holy Spirit would abide, that all that's said and done would be pleasing in your sight. You are our strength. You are our Redeemer. Amen and amen. This first song is one of my new favorite songs. Come on, stand up with me. Those of you that are at home, you are not exempted from praising God and worshiping God, because that's what we're here to do on today. I don't care what you're going through,
just think about
what you're facing in life. Just know that he is still on the throne. Amen. Amen. He is so worthy of all of the praise we have in our hearts. He's worthy. Thank you, Lord.
And nothing can take me away from his love. Why should I worry?
Why
should I fear?
Why should we fear?
Jesus
is near.
I'm safe in his arms.
I'm safe.
Safe in his heart.
Yes.
And nothing can take me
away. I praise God. See, the Holy Spirit knew that we needed this to be the first song on today, so that we can definitely feel the Holy Spirit's presence, so that it would touch us first. It's no way to minister to somebody else if it isn't touching and blessing us. Thank you, Lord. He's always good, you all. And he loves like a father should. Just think about it. What a mighty God. Yes. When I'm afraid, you all, we should all be calling on his name. Yes, safe. Hallelujah.
He's the King.
Yes, he's the Lord, God of everything. Hallelujah. That he's still on the throne and that he reigns forevermore. There's not a time in our lives that he isn't right there with us. He's in control, you all. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you for covering us. We just think about it. Just think about it. When we wake up in the morning, we ought to be thinking about it. When we go to bed at night, we ought to be thinking about it. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory to his name. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, yes. Praise him. Praise him. Woo! He's worthy, you all. Glory to your name. Always. He's never going to let us down. Hey! God. He's on the throne. If we can't praise him when we come into his house, when can we praise him? Thank you, Lord. We give you glory for an opportunity, Lord. Nothing separates us.
Nothing can separate us from the love of God. No mountain, no valley.
Ooh, what a mighty God. What a mighty God we serve. I just praise God today that he continues to sit on the throne, that he reigns forevermore. And when I just think about it, how he has kept us and how he has blessed us and how he has protected us, because when we see these terrible things happening to people on the news, but for the grace of God, that would be us. Oh, it's not because we live in the right neighborhood. That's not it. It's not because we don't drive that fancy, fancy car. That's not it. It is because of his grace, his mercy, the love that he has for us, the fact that he gave his life for us. I just praise God for being who he is. Amen and amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He loves us, you all.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me.
Yes.
You have been so,
he's
so,
been so good, so
good
to
me.
Us, Lord. We can't help but be grateful.
Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me.
More than I ever could deserve.
Oh, the overwhelming,
more than any of us could deserve.
Never ending, reckless love of God. Oh, he chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99.
Yes,
I couldn't earn it. I don't deserve
it. He left it all to come get me,
yourself
to save me,
oh,
to rescue me. It's a personal praise, you all. And you got to be thinking about it. How different our lives could have been gone. Yeah, we had some hard times, but we still here. That is something to be so thankful for. Glory, glory, glory.
When I was your foe, still your love fought for me.
You know, because when we were doing wrong, he still kept
you
us.
You have been so, so good to
when
me.
We do wrong today, he's still keeping us.
When I felt
when we do
worth,
wrong on tomorrow,
you paid it all,
he's still
me.
Keeping us. Thank you,
you
for loving
been
us.
So, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Oh,
I'm just so thankful that it never ends.
Fights till
forever and for always. Hebrews 11:8, it says he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. That's something to be thankful for, you all. His love never changes. The love he had for us that caused him to give his son Jesus for us is the love he continues to have for us today. Amen. Amen. Glory to your name.
There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me.
Yes.
There's no wall
I praise
you won't
God
kick
that there's
down,
no trouble that I can get myself
down,
into
coming after
that
me.
He still won't come after me.
There's no shadow
that's
you
just
won't
how much
light
he loves
up,
us,
mountain
you, all.
You won't climb up, coming after
oh,
me.
Oh, thank you, Lord, for loving us. Thank you for never giving up on us. Thank you for coming to get us out of the trouble we got ourselves into. Oh, hallelujah. We love you, Lord. And we say thank you on today. We love you, Lord. And we say thank you on today. We love you, Lord. And we say thank you on today. I didn't earn it. And we know we didn't deserve it. Forgive us, Father, for falling short. Forgive us, Father, for all of our sins. And thank you, Lord, for just continuing to love us. Amen and amen. He is so worthy of all of our praise, and we just can't thank him enough, you all. I know, at least for me, there have been days and times when I know I was not doing the right thing. I'm sorry, Lord, but thank you. Thank you for keeping me in spite of myself. And I know I'm not the only one with that testimony on today. There's not a one of us that can't look back to a day and time where he picked us up. Ooh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And you know, he did it once, he'll do it again. Yeah, didn't I say the same yesterday, today, and forever? He is faithful, you all. Yes, hallelujah.
When the whispers of worry overwhelm my soul, you never left me alone.
Yes, he never left us alone, you all.
You were there all alone.
He was there all alone. Can depend on you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I was down to the wire.
Yes.
Hoping you'd come.
There were times when I just didn't know if I was gonna make it through.
Then you stepped.
I didn't know if I could survive it.
Like you always.
When the pain in our hearts is just so appear, it just hurts, but he still was right there. Yes, he continued to love us, and as long as we look to him, we'll make it through, you all. Take that message with you on today. As long as we look to him, we'll make it through. I know we're going through some hard times, but look to him. He's faithful, you all. He's faithful. He's faithful. And he's not going to change. He did it once, and he'll do it again. Yes. What a word of encouragement. Think about all the times that he kept us. Think about all the times that he rescued us. And know in your hearts that if he did it again, did it then, he will do it again. That's just the kind of God we serve. He's a faithful God. Huh. Thank you, Lord. Yes, tell him, how great is your faithfulness. Yes, let him hear you. How great is your faithfulness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. There's none like you in all the earth. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. us, Lord. Come give us. Thank you, Lord. To fear, no reason to be afraid, because he's faithful. And he's not gonna change. Glory. Thank you, Lord, for moving. Thank you, Lord, for touching. Oh, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You're faithful. Oh, I hear you, Lord. I hear you. Thank you. Thank you for speaking. Thank you for speaking. You're faithful, Lord. There is no doubt that no matter what we're going through, that he's gonna show up. That he's gonna show up. I'm just grateful for that on today, you all. And I can't say that enough, because I know where I've been. And I know what I've faced, what I've gone through. I know how I felt. And he was right there. When we needed him most, you all, he was right there, picking us up and carrying us. He never lost us. Sometimes we strayed away from him, but he was always right there. Amen and amen for that. Thank you, Lord. And the least we could do is say thank you. I mean, I think that's the least we could do, is say thank you. Express our gratitude towards him. And we all praise God differently. For some, it's a hand in the air. For some, it's singing a song. Yes. For some, it's running in place. Yes. For some, it's clapping and stomping. Yes. Whatever method that you may use to show God that you appreciate him, do that.
As I often do.
Hallelujah.
But every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much.
I wish I had something more to give you, Lord. I do.
Except for hearts.
But I'm giving you what I have. We're giving you what we have.
Hallelujah. I've got one response.
As good as you are to us, the least we can do is say thank you.
With my arms stretched wide, I will worship you. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a heart.
But it's what we have. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We have so much to be grateful for. For life in our bodies, we have a lot to be thankful for. my soul. For a place to live, we have a lot to be grateful for.
Cause you've got a light inside of those lungs.
You know, I'm grateful. Let me tell you one thing I'm grateful for Dennis Brock, my husband.
Oh, come on, my soul.
God blessed me that I might experience true love. Everybody can't say that.
You've got a lion inside.
Thank you, Lord. I miss him. Every day I miss him. But I'm thankful. I'm thankful, Lord.
Come on, my soul. Oh,
because he showed me what it means to truly be loved. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Get up and praise the Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And I praise you today. I worship you today. I honor you today. I lift up your name more today. You're just so near. Lord. Oh, no. No reason to be angry. No reason to be sad. That don't mean I don't listen, but it's no reason to be upset with God. Because he's just too good. Be grateful. Even when things aren't going how we would want them to go, be grateful.
Cause all that I have is a heart.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king. Except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes, yes, I just praise God on today. Hallelujah. I'm feeling a little bit better, y'all. You can have a seat. You can have a seat. We praise God on today. Hallelujah. I was struggling. My super struggle light was on today. But I just praise God because his Holy Spirit touches and moves. Woo, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. It's giving time. If it's time for you to give, if today is your day to give, feel free to do so even now. Feel free to do so. Amen and amen. 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 Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you on this day, Lord, with joy in our hearts, Heavenly Father. We have you on our mind, and we thank you on today because you have been so gracious, so kind, so loving towards us. And no matter where we are in life, Lord, we pray that you would continue to walk with us and talk with us, Lord. Continue to be in the midst. Continue to keep us and cover us, Lord. We just say thank you. Oh, hallelujah. You're so worthy, Lord. And in our hearts, we give you all that we have. And we definitely say thank you, Lord. Oh, right now in the name of Jesus, we know that there are some that are sick, Lord Jesus. We pray that you would be with them. Wherever they may be, Lord, they need you. Touch. There are some that are bereaved, that are going through hard times. Touch, Lord. I know that there are some that are traveling, Heavenly Father. Please keep them. Cover them as they drive or fly or however they get to their destination. Cover them, Lord. And then, Heavenly Father, our prayer is that you would continue to walk with us and talk with us. Heavenly Father, we pray over any offerings that have been given, Lord, that your blessings would touch and honor the gift. Heavenly Father, that you would give an increase, an increase beyond our imaginations. And we just give you all the praise and honor and the glory. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen, amen. It is now time for our sermonic message. This afternoon's sermonic message comes from Leviticus, the 26th chapter, the 3rd through the 5th verses. Leviticus, the 26th chapter, the 3rd through the 5th verse. And it reads, "If you follow my statutes and keep my commandments and observe them faithfully, I will give you your rains in their season, and the land shall yield its produce, and the trees of the field shall yield their fruit. Your threshing shall overtake the vintage, and the vintage shall overtake the sowing. You shall eat your bread to the full and live securely in your land." Amen and amen for the reading and hearing of God's word. A quick word of prayer. Lord, allow your Holy Spirit to move. Allow your message to go forward with power, Lord, that only comes from you. Allow this message, Lord, to be a blessing to these your people, Heavenly Father, in the same way that this word absolutely is a blessing unto me. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. The subject of today's sermonic message, secure living. Secure living. Now, let me just say this. I praise God for the Holy Spirit because I know that it makes sense that since I put together the music for the praise and worship portion of the service, that it would line up so well with the scripture text, but I do not put it together that way. All week long, different songs come to me in my spirit. Then on Saturday, when I'm putting together the music video for the praise and worship portion, the Holy Spirit just tells me which order to put the songs, which songs we need to sing. And I just praise God because on today, we heard a whole lot about God still being on the throne. We heard a whole lot about him taking care of us and protecting us and keeping us and covering us. And then we come into today's sermonic message, and the subject is secure living. Woo! We have so much to be thankful for. Amen. Amen. It seems like all this year, at some point in nearly every sermonic message, whether on Saturday or Sunday, I end up saying something like, life is hard. And I wish that I could tell you all something different. I wish that I could tell you all that the older you get, the easier it's gonna get. Just not so. I wish that I could tell you all that the more saved you are, if that could be a thing, the easier life will be, but that's just not so. I wish that I could tell you all the more you go to church, the easier life will be. I just can't tell you that. Because we are sinful creatures living in a sinful world, life is hard. And one thing I don't understand is how people who don't have God in their lives make it. I know for me and many of you that the only way we're able to get through is because we're holding on to God. The hope for yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And so if you don't have God to hold on to, how are you making it? And I think the sad indictment is that we see how they're making it. They aren't. Life is beating them up on every end. And my prayer is that we as Christians can do something to make their load a little bit lighter. And the very first thing we could do is tell them about Jesus. We talked about evangelism last week. That's the first thing we should be doing. Oh, wait. We didn't talk about evangelism last week. That's tomorrow's sermon. So, amen. I just love the Lord. You all know that I got Saturday and Sunday sermons I'm working on all at the same time. So tune in tomorrow and you'll get the evangelizing message. If we didn't have God in our lives, we would be nervous. And there are some of us, even with God in our lives, that experience those kinds of feelings of anxiety. Nervous to go outside because we're saying so much is happening in this world, I'm going to just stay home. Nervous to take on any new tasks, to try new things. We get nervous. We get nervous. And we shouldn't. We have fear. Fear that the worst case scenario is going to happen. I've been around people like that who only see the bad and who can never see the good. And it's so sad for people to live that way, to have a feeling that they won't survive whatever situation they're in, that they can't get through it, or have an apprehension, wanting to try new things but just can't. They just can't do it. I pray that that's none of us on today. But I know at different times it is us. There are some times that we just get nervous, that we have apprehension, that we live in fear. I know that. But as Christians, we should be ready to just jump out here and live life. I know I talk about myself often, but hey, I'm an open book and I got the mic. As a widow, one of the things, and I'm going to be with some people later on today, and that's what we're going to be talking about. And those of you that are widowers who understand what I'm saying, it can be a little scary to think about dating again or getting in another relationship of almost any type, to move forward without our person in our lives. But you know what? One thing a Christian should never be is afraid. You could be cautious, and we're going to talk about that in just a minute, but not afraid. And we should be prepared to jump out here when we're ready. And I'm not saying Brock is ready today. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is I'm not afraid, because my God is the same yesterday, to get today, and forever. And if he blessed me with real love once, he can do it again. And so I just praise God for that. There is so much out here in this world that we have not experienced, that we have not seen or done. And sometimes we just need to make up in our minds to just give it a try. Just give it a try. I know that even these praise and worship services aren't easy for some people. There are some that come in here and have no problem praising God. But I also know that there are some who are nervous about it, or who have apprehension, who are fearful about giving God that kind of public praise. And so until you're ready, you do what you need to do. But we pray that you will join us in offering that kind of outward praise to God. But that was just a side note. Living a secure life is pretty easy, you all. I love when preachers and pastors say stuff like that, because we all know it's not easy. Oh, it's pretty easy, you all. All we need to do is what today's text tells us to do. Today's text tells us that we need to follow his decrees. And as saved children of God, when we follow his decrees, we will be secure. In other words, I'm talking about following the word of God, you all. What he has told us in his word. Now, no, it does not mean we will never have a problem. That's not what being secure means. It doesn't mean that things won't go wrong in our lives. It doesn't mean that the new thing that we try that we'll even like it. For someone like me that at 53 one day would like to be in another committed relationship, there's no guarantee that whoever I meet or date that that's gonna work out. There's just no guarantee in this life. But it does mean that when we follow his word that we are protected, that there is a covering around us, that things will not happen to us that break us on the inside to a place where we can't recover. I'm thankful for that. If no one else is thankful, I'm thankful for that. Because we are following God's word. We're doing what he tells us to do, and that's very important in our lives. So even though we don't know what's waiting for us around the corner, we can trust that we are going to be okay. And maybe that's what the real message is on today. When we follow him the way we're supposed to, we're going to be okay. I know that there are some watching and even in this room that are facing unimaginable situations. And it feels like it's just not gonna work out. It feels like it's just the end of the world. But the one thing I can promise is that when we follow God, we will make it through it. And we will be okay. See, there are laws in the Bible. That's what we gotta follow. An easy one, thou shalt not steal. When we follow his law, that's one less thing that we have to concern ourselves about. Because don't think that criminals have an easy life, because they don't. It's something to be involved in crimes and not even be able to sleep at night because you don't know if somebody's going to try to kill you. It's not easy being involved in a life of crime and not knowing when you're going to get caught. To always be watching your back, to always be scared and nervous. I know that those that are involved in that lifestyle make it look easy. No such thing is the case, because life is hard and it don't matter who you are. The only difference is that the difficulties they're facing are because they're violating God's laws. Yeah. A directive, an example of one of his directives, pray continually. It says in his word that we're to pray continually. He directs us to do that. And when we follow his directives, we will be in a closer relationship with God. See, that's how come we'll end up being secure, you all, because we're walking with him. He is right there with us because we are doing what he says for us to do. We're following his directives, that closer relationship with God. We'll be able to hear from him when he's speaking to us. And that's just so important when we're making life decisions. Oh, how do we know whether to go left or right if we aren't talking to him? And then there's commands. There's an example of a command: in all things, give thanks. Whew, that's a rough one, you all. And I've heard other preachers say, so allow me to say it on today. This word didn't say for all things, give thanks. So I'm not thanking God for all things, but I'm certainly thanking him in them. And I'm praising him right in the middle of it, because it's an easy thing to praise God when things are going right.
but oh, to praise him when they aren't. It's a wonderful thing, and it'll allow us to keep our minds on him when we give him thanks in all things. I think last week I preached a sermon, yes, continually. We are to continually say thank you. You all have to go watch that message. It talks about it. Yeah. So please note the three areas, the three things that I just said. When we're living lives that are according to God's word, we have less to concern ourselves with. I need that. We will be in a closer relationship with God. I need that. And we will keep our minds on God. I just praise God for that, because we're talking about secure living today and how to get it. And to have the security that God promises in texts like today, that's all we need to do, is adhere to his word. So yeah, in addition, this text tells us that we need to keep and observe his commandments. And please hear this. Knowing what God's word says is not enough. There are some of us that can quote the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, and we'll cuss you out in the parking lot of the church. Knowing God's word is not enough. We have to make it a life choice, a life decision, a lifestyle. We have to do something more. I'll say knowing the word is a great place to start, because at least if we know it, we know what we should or shouldn't be doing. But again, that's not enough. We have to obey his word. We have to do what it says for us to do. So let's be careful. Remember, I said a few moments ago that we have to be cautious as we get out here and live the life that God promised us. Go ahead. Go out here and live. Quit sitting at home all the time. Get out here and live. But be cautious. Be careful. Where we go, we need to be careful. If we already know it's a history of violence occurring at that place, what kind of crazy would tell us, I got God with me, so I'm going to the place anyway? That's just not common sense. But certainly we should be careful about where we go, what we say and what we do, especially what we do. And we have to be watchful for situations that may lead us into sin. Be watchful. You know, sin don't just slip up. We try to say it slipped up on us, but it didn't just slip up on us. It started out as a seed, a thought, and then it started out with an action. And then the next thing you know, we were in the place and did the thing that we knew God would have us not to do. We knew the conversation was taking a turn, and we were getting ready to start saying something that would not be pleasing unto God. We have to be watchful for these situations that will somehow just come upon us. And we have to be alert. We have to be on our P's and Q's, because Satan is always out to get us. And if he could cause us to fall, he will. And certainly for me as a pastor, and this does not apply to just me, but for me as a pastor, if he could cause my fall to be public and humiliating, then he's done his day's work. Oh, my, my, my. This is why we need the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will speak to us through God's word, speak to us through prayer, and speak in our spirits, telling us, don't go there. Learn to listen to our gut feelings, you all. It'll tell us, don't be alone. Don't go. Don't say it. We need to follow that gut feeling. And we call it a gut feeling, you all, but that's nothing but the Holy Spirit. So in case any of us did not know how to hear the Holy Spirit, God is speaking to us when our gut tells us something is wrong. And then sometimes we don't want to do what the Holy Spirit is telling us to do. We want to go do that other thing. It feels good to us. We want to hold that conversation. We like to gossip. We want to just know what's going on with other people. But certainly, do what the Word of God says and what the Holy Spirit tells us to do anyway. Because we're talking about secure living today. And just know that the reward is worth the effort that we put in to adhere, to observe, to follow God's word. The reward far outweighs any sort of, I don't know, inconvenience that we may have. And I'm going to hurry on because I know we got communion today and we started a few minutes late. But let me give you the rewards. And these rewards are plentiful. Amen for that. Rain will fall. That's what this text tells us. Rain will fall just when we need it. And sometimes we see rain as a bad thing, but it's not always a bad thing. Rain is a gift from God, and it is a blessing. It is a blessing. Because sometimes the rain that falls in our lives is something that hurts us, something that we would rather not have happening, but it draws us that much closer to God. I know it didn't feel like it at the time. All we could yell out was, Lord, let the rain stop. When in essence, we hadn't prayed in a long time until the rain started. The rain is a blessing, you all, and it's a gift from God. And we get that hard time rain when we need it. But then rain is also a blessing because sometimes it waters us because we need to be watered. Because nothing in our lives is working. It's not growing. It's not prospering. And we need the rain to come and renew us, to regenerate us, to revive us, to get us going again. See, God knew that we needed that. And he blessed us with it. And it's nothing better than getting rain in its due season. You see, when we get rain in the depth of winter, it's a problem. That's not the season for rain, not in the Midwest. That's the season for snow. But if you get too much rain during that period, it ices right over. The wind hit it and it causes a problem on the roads. You can't see it half the time. Hear what's being said on today. When the rain is out of season, it causes problems in our lives and difficulties, and we can't even see it getting ready to happen. So rain in its season is a good thing. Rain right now, and I could stand to get a break from the rain because my grass is growing way too fast. But even that is good because the flowers need the rain. The soil needs the rain. We need the rain. So we just have to accept that all rain is not bad, because when rain falls in our lives, we will grow as a person. We get stronger. You know, life's trauma and trials and tribulations has made us stronger people. Our lives will grow. Our finances will grow. Our spirits will grow. We will have the fruit of the Spirit in our lives. That's what this text told us. That it will rain and we will have fruit overflowing in our lives. We absolutely will be able to harvest what comes because of the rain. So as those things that God purposed for us grows up in our lives, we'll be able to gather it unto ourselves and make use of it. We'll be able to reap what we've sown. And for all that we've reaped, we certainly will get to a place of being able to eat, of what we have gathered. I just praise God for that, because remember, we're talking about secure living. How do we get to a place of being comfortable in God, in knowing that all is going to be well, that we're safe, that we are secure? The way we do it is through following His word. I pray that we don't miss that today, that He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We just need to do what He's telling us to do. Follow His word, ladies and gentlemen, that we might indeed be able to live secure lives. This is no big secret, you all. This is no big secret. It's just that we don't want to do it. Secure living, you all. Secure living. This text tells us, let me read it for you as I close. If you follow my statutes and keep my commandments and observe them faithfully, I will give you your rains in their season, and the land shall yield its produce, and the trees of the field shall yield their fruit. Your threshing shall overtake the vintage, and the vintage shall overtake the sowing. You shall eat your bread to the full, more than enough, amen, and live securely in your land, amen. Amen and amen. I pray that we all would accept and understand that following God's word is the key to having secure living. Speak to me, Lord. Allow me to receive this message. And my prayer is that each of us feels the same. Amen and amen. I praise God for the word of God. This song in particular, come on, stand up with me, and we're going to wrap it up and do our communion. Those of you that are at home, grab your crackers and juice, because when this song is over, we're going to do our communion service. This song, I've said it before, caught me by surprise.
Above all kings,
that He is above all.
Above all nature and all created things.
Yes. I just thank Him for taking such good care of us, you all.
You were here before the world began.
Yes.
Above all kingdoms.
He is above all.
Above all.
The love He showers on us, above all.
Above all.
The sacrifice He gave for us, above all. I just praise God for it on today.
And treasures of the earth.
I pray, Lord, that you were pleased.
There's no way to measure what you're worth.
Yes, there's no way to measure what He's worth.
Crucified,
He was crucified for us.
Lay behind the stump. Live to die. Rejected and
right there. He took it all. And thought about us above all. I just praise God. He's such a great God.
Above all powers. Above all kings.
Yes.
Above all nature and all created things. Above all wisdom.
Yes. Before the world began. This may make the cut for tomorrow's
above
list.
All kingdoms,
oh, hallelujah.
Above all thrones,
the communion we're going to serve. This is all about
wonders
it.
The world has ever known.
Hallelujah.
Above all wealth and treasures of the earth.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. That touches my heart. And all we have to do is follow his lead, follow the word of God, and all that our hearts desire, we will have. Amen. Amen. I just thank you for that. It is time for our communion service. Remember, I told you all, yes, please feel free to have a seat. I told you all that on the first Saturday of the month, we will have communion service here on Saturdays in our praise and worship service, so that anyone who attends only on Saturday won't have to concern themselves with missing of the communion, the serving of observance of communion. So our Lord and Savior, we know he died for us, but on that last night when he was hanging out with his BFFs, the 12, he knew that this was it for him. And I often comment that I can only imagine how he felt knowing that he would never see any of these people again. Not on this side of glory anyway. Well, let me fix that up a little bit. Not as the human, alive, walking and talking, master and teacher that he was when he was living as a man. So maybe I cleaned that up enough. Because we know that he certainly showed himself to them again before he went to heaven. And we know that he continued to minister to them and teach them. We know all of that. But this was the last time that he would be able to be with them in this way. And he said to them, you know, we're going to eat. And he took the bread. And when he took it, he blessed it. And he broke it. And he said, this is my body that has been broken for you. And whenever you eat it, I would only ask that you do it in remembrance of me. Just a quick word of prayer. Heavenly Father, our prayer today is that we would recognize this body of Jesus Christ, that it would act as a remembrance for us of the sacrifice that he gave for us, the death, the burial, the beatings, Heavenly Father, the resurrection. We just thank you even right now for Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Take and eat of the bread. On that same night, he took the cup after they had eaten. And he said to his disciples, he said, listen, this drink, this cup, represents my blood. And because of the blood, we have a new agreement, a new covenant between you and I. A new agreement, a new arrangement. And you know, now, he didn't say this, but let me add it. You will be able to go directly to the Father. I thank God for that. But he also said to them, as often as you drink of this cup, you do that in remembrance of me. And let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ. We thank you that because of the blood, we have an opportunity to live eternal lives with you, that he was the ultimate sacrifice, that he gave his life for us, and we're just ever, ever so grateful for it. In the precious name of Jesus, amen. Take and drink. As is the tradition in the Baptist denomination, we do not do a benediction at that usually first Sunday service. So on today, we will not do a benediction. But I will say, go out here into this world that really seems to be turned upside down.
And over this next 30-day period, try to do something, some little thing to help turn it right side up. Amen and amen. Know that I am praying for you, and my prayer is that you are praying for me. Amen and amen.
You are.
need.